the Board of Directors for SCRC Southern California Renewal Conference and Assistant Coordinator of the OC Chapter of Magnificum. Let's give her a warm welcome, Dr. Elizabeth Hayes.
In the name of Father and Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Come, Holy Spirit. Fill our hearts with your presence, with your power. And all who is out of you, please remove from our hearts so we can listen to your voice. Continue to increase the charisms in our lives for your greater honor and glory. Our Lady of Sorrows, pray for us. Blessed Elena of Guaya,
pray for us.
Pope Leo XIII,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
In the name of Father, and Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I'm very happy to be here today with you. How many of you is the first time doing Life of the Spirit Center? Almost like 40%. Welcome. And rest are repeaters. Very good. I've been attending and conducting Life in the Spirit seminar more than 20 times in my life. And I think that every time I go through it, it is new because God is ever new. He has so much to teach us every time if we let Him. Before we begin, I want to do a little exercise. I hope you guys will stand up. When I walked in this auditorium, this hall, I sensed the beauty of your faith. All of you exuberate this beautifully happy faith here. And I sense this is the upper room, and our Mother Mary is watching over us. She's dripping her mantle around all of us. So today will be, since it started yesterday, a very special day. And the good news is, Holy Spirit already showed up in Fullerton, California. Amen? Amen. So anything that is distracting us, let's put your two fingers both here. And as Jesus opened the person with death, he said, be opened, be opened. And in Hebrew, it was Ephatha. So let's say, in Jesus' name, we say, Ephatha. So everything is open us. Our spiritual ears, spiritual eyes, spiritual hearts, to receive Him alone in His truth, His word of life, which gives us hope and love and joy and peace the world cannot give. Amen?
Please
be seated. So this session I supposed to cover the charism of the Holy Spirit. But before I begin, I thought it may be a good idea to talk about why we need charisms and where this charism is coming from. And maybe the brief review of history of Catholic charismatic renewal. Catholic charismatic renewal began around the 19th century. From 1st century to 19th century, since Jesus' resurrection ascension, church went through exponential exploration of the Holy Spirit, and we produced so many saints and martyrs, etc. From 1895 to 1903, how many of you familiar with Blessed Elena Guerra of Italy? Blessed Elena Guerra of Lucca, Italy, she was the nun from Apostle of the Holy Spirit. And she wrote 13 letters to Pope Leo XIII requesting renewed preaching of the Holy Spirit. So she is the grandmother of the Catholic Charismatic Renewal. I already asked her intercession for Catholic Charismatic Renewal. And because Pope Leo XIII was very docile to the Holy Spirit, 1895, he listened to the Spirit and he exalted the entire church to celebrate the solemn novena to the Holy Spirit each year between Ascension to the Pentecost. So that's where novena to the Holy Spirit began. In 1897, he mandated the Pentecost novena. Then around the time, 1901, Pope Leo XIII again intoned the hymn Veni Creator Spiritus. I know you guys will know that, right? That song. He's the one who intoned it. And he dedicated the whole church to Holy Spirit. And around that time, while this is going on in Catholic Church, 1901, Topeka, Kansas City, there was a Protestant pastor named by Charles Parham. And his students dedicated themselves to study the baptism of the Holy Spirit, which is the result of a revival of Pentecostalism in Protestant church. And then immediately after the 1906, Azusa Street, very here in our backyard in Los Angeles, the Pentecostal movement grew without outpouring of the Spirit. I remember reading the story that in Azusa, there was a glory of God like a cloud were there for days and days and days. Everybody who went there received something and changed right away. And some years later, 1961, our dear Pope Saint John 23rd prayed to convene Second Vatican Council. He invoked the Holy Spirit by saying, "Renew your wonders in our time as by a new Pentecost." So he set a tone, and guess what happened? 6 years later, 1967, February, students and professors, Duke University, had retreat, confirmation retreat, and then the Ark and the Dove retreat house in Pittsburgh, especially North Hills of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. And that is the breaking out of the Catholic Charismatic Renewal. We just celebrated 2017, 50 years or the Jubilee year of Catholic Charismatic Renewal. And I was there, and I happened to be at the retreat house, the Ark and the Dove, the very chapel, the small students and professors receive the Holy Spirit. And out of that, over 120 million Catholics have been baptized in the Holy Spirit. And we are the part of it. And Pope Francis called this is current of grace. Baptism in the Holy Spirit is the identity of Catholic Charismatic Renewal. We are called current of grace. This current of grace, we are the part of it. Is for the church, for the word, for ourselves, for everybody. So we are very, very fortunate and blessed. I was remembering my own life when I first time went to Life in the Spirit seminar in Seoul, Korea, years ago. It was actually in 1976 when I was 2 years old. You know, like I didn't know what it was, but I heard it was kind of second time offering in coordination of Korea. I went there, and this what we are doing is such a fresh course. We are doing 1.5 days, but we did it 8 weeks. We have a lot to study, we have a lot to read. But in just going through it, my faith upside down and inside out, I didn't have that kind of faith. Not that I have good faith now, I'm still trying to grow,